Hello everyone. Today's video is on a recent issue around the Sabarimala temple, which I think many of you might be already aware of. So there are a few things I wanted to point out about this temple and its cultural heritage, more from a religious point of view, not from the legal aspect. There's already a lot of updates from the legal side, but I want to point out the cultural significance of the temple and of Hindu temples in general. So the first thing I wanted to point out to some of the journalists who are crying out loud about not being women of the reproductive age not being allowed into the temple is that it is not your, you know, baap ki jagir, it is not your abba jaan ki jhopdi, aapka ghar nahi hai, aapki ye jagir nahi hai. You can't just bulldoze and, you know, try to just force your ideologies into an existing institution which has been alive for a really, really long time. So these temples are really, really ancient temples which have been in existence for a very long time, much before these jurnas came into existence, right? So I'll go point by point. There are several things I wanted to share. So the first thing is that in Hinduism, each temple has a specific energy field. I'm not saying energy, I'm saying energy field. There's a difference. So don't come to me with silly arguments like, oh, it's all energy. No, it's not all energy. Every temple, especially the ancient temples, where the deity, jahan pe jo pran pratishtha hoti hai deity ki, that was done with specific mantras, with specific dhatus, materials or metals, which was installed in the base of the deity to create a specific energy field, which gave certain benefits to the people who would be coming there and worshipping the deity. So for example, Kalahasti temple is really famous for removing all the doshas of the planet, the nine planets, the grahas. So I'll speak in Hindi also in between. So hamare dharm mein, har mandir mein jo pran pratishtha hoti hai, wo ek energy field create karne ke upalaksh se करी जाती है. उसके लिए कुछ मंत्र वो जाप करते हैं और कुछ कुछ धातुएं उसमें डाली जाती हैं, उसके बेस में जो मूर्ति है उसके बेस में. इससे वो कई सारे मुश्किलों का, कई सारी प्रॉब्लम्स का निवारण होता है जब आप उस टेंपल में जाते हैं. सो ईच टेंपल इज यूनिक, हर टेंपल यूनिक होता है फॉर दिस एनर्जी फील्ड एंड जो डेटी है. सो जैसे दिस सबरीमला इज फॉर अय्यप्पा डेटी, सो देयर आर सेवरल अदर टेंपल्स for other different gods, right? So now in Sabarimala, the rishis who did this pran pratishtha knew this science of doing this pran pratishtha and creating a specific energy field. So the deity there is, as some of you might already be knowing, it is a male naishtik brahmachari form of Ayyappa. So it is Lord Ayyappa in a specific form, not just this generalization of all deities is a very, very stupid thing which many Hindus tend to do. Oh, it's all God, everyone is the same. No, it's not the same. Let me tell you very categorically, not just all gods are not the same, different forms of the same God are also not the same. Each different form of each God has a certain energy, has certain qualities, manifests certain qualities. So Mahadeva is worshipped in so many forms, but each form of Mahadeva has specific qualities. His Dakshinamurti form is completely different from his Kal Bhairava form, right? So don't do this kind of stupid generalization. So the Ayyappa deity in Sabarimala is a Brahmachari, Naishtik Brahmachari, right? And one of the vows of Brahmacharya is, of course, you know, Brahmacharya itself, which is, there are five vows of Brahmacharya. And just so you know, Brahmacharya is practiced by male and females both in Hinduism. It is a gender neutral practice and it is irrespective of age. Anybody can take a Brahmacharya. It is not, it is not pertaining to a certain age. This is just FYI, because many people are, sharing a whole lot of stupid things around that also. So the state cannot interfere in the subtleties of a religion unless they understand the subtleties of the religion and unless they're ready to uphold the guidelines which are set by the people who understood these subtleties of the religion. So the rishis who installed the deity, who set certain guidelines for that temple, knew this science and were implementing this science. Now it is worth noting, how come nobody has asked the question that only in Sabarimala temple, women of reproducing age are not allowed? It's not like women are not allowed in general. Women are allowed in general in all temples. As per Agamas, as per Shastras, they are allowed. But if in one specific temple they are not allowed, there is a certain intelligence behind it. There is certain, guidance behind it. It is very silly to call it a discrimination. If you're going to call it a discrimination, then there should be a bigger sample space, right? There should be more data. You're talking about just one temple that took guideline for one group of women. And you're calling that as discrimination out of your own assumptions of why women are not allowed. So the energy of this temple is not good for women of that age, first of all. And second of all, the deity who is installed in that temple did not wish women of that age to come and worship him, because it is not meant for women at all. It is meant for men. That temple is meant for men who want to worship Ayyappa in that form, right? So these are some subtleties of the religion which you cannot understand if you are not of that religion and if you are not practicing, actively practicing that religion. If you don't understand what is devotion, if you don't understand what is the difference between God A and God B, you are literally nobody to comment on the practice. And it is not like they are hurting anybody. They're not going and commenting on any woman and saying, oh, you are impure. All these words like impure and all this nonsense is coming just from others who are commenting on the temple. The temple deity is not going and calling women impure. So please stop applying your own stupid ideas to a holy place which you know nothing about and which you understand nothing about. Right? So other question which I want to ask these so-called activists and these Judnos is, why are women not allowed in all the mosques and Haji Ali? Why isn't anybody crying out loud and, you know, protesting and filing PILs about that? Why not? Why this hypocrisy? Why is there so much hypocrisy? If you're going to interfere in religious practices, do that for all religions or shut your mouth and don't do anything. The other aspect, I'm going point by point because I don't want to miss any point. The other thing is, the idea of secularism which is being applied to temples itself is inherently stupid, because secularism is applied to places and concepts and bodies or organizations which are not of a religious character, right? But a temple is obviously a religious place. It's the most obvious thing there is. So why are you applying your secularism to a temple? It is not meant to be applied to a temple. It is meant to be applied to you as the state, right? So as the state, you should be applying secularism by not differentiating between a temple and a mosque and questioning the mosque also, if at all you're going to question. And if you're not going to question, then you should not be questioning a temple also, and you should not be trying to implement your own ideas. And my question is not just for the state. My question is also for all these Judnos who are coming and giving all these stupid statements about the temples, who don't know a thing about Hinduism. So all those who are ignorant about Hinduism should not go and blabber about Hinduism and talk nonsense about Hinduism non-stop. This is not okay. And all the Hindus who are digesting this nonsense, you are basically understand what you are digesting. You're digesting the nonsense of some person who knows zilch about Hinduism. So tomorrow, are you going to come and tell us what prasad we should offer at what temple? Like, what is your reason? What is your logical reasoning behind it at all? Right? So, like I said, I started it at the absolutely right point, which is that it is not your Abba Jan ki jhopadi. You know, it is not your property to decide who goes there and who does not go there. The deity who was installed, the rishis and the munis who installed the deity knew what they were doing, and they set certain guidelines for the benefit of all mankind. So please use a little brain and try to learn about these customs and respect these customs and traditions instead of going and applying your silly communist ideologies to it. This is all I have to say to everybody who is crying out loud and hyperventilating over why menstruating women are not allowed in Sabarimala. So, and anybody who's commenting on my videos, please make an effort to watch my videos before commenting nonsense on my videos. If you comment nonsense without watching my videos, I will delete your comment and I will ban you from the page or the channel. No, please note that well. So I would recommend all of you to please share my video with anybody who is, doing this nonsense or who is believing this nonsense, because this understanding of temples is, getting wiped out from Bharat. So thank you for watching, and please ask me sensible questions if you have any. Thank you.